Furniture Channel. Tufaq is a market leader in home office furniture products. Today we are going to show you the inspiration for one of our popular chair models, AMU. Now the chair is received in DIY format. It is do-it-yourself format in a box like this. Now this box roughly weighs around 12 kg. The card you receive will have this marking wherein it will have your order number, your delivery details and the other details that you have marked while you place the order. So the installation of this chair is going to take between 10 to 15 minutes, and I request you to kindly watch this video till the end and follow the instructions given as in the video while you do the installation at home. So happy working at home. We are going to start the installation. So first step is to open the carton with any sharp object, preferably while you are starting the installation. Just ensure that you have a screwdriver, which normally is available in all the homes. Though even if you don't have a screwdriver, still the installation is possible because there is a tool inside there to install the chair. Now, starting the first step, you open the carton. So the chair parts that you receive would be something like this. So you'll have a base, the back, the seat, mechanism, gas lift, and the tool that I was talking about, the Allen key, and the handles in this case. So we are just going to follow the instructions while we do the installation. So the first step is the seat. We are going to uncover the seat. So step number one, place the seat on the table or the floor, and if you see in the seat, you will find these holes, these bolts. Now these bolts are all hand screwed just for the purpose so that they can be unscrewed again. If you see, there are 3 plus 3 6 and 4 10 bolts. So make sure that you don't lose these bolts. So one very specific request, once you start the installation, don't leave the hardware, otherwise there's a possibility of losing the hardware. So once you start the chair, it's going to take just 15 minutes. Just complete the installation before you move on to any other. So okay, so now this chair comes with two different kinds of Allen keys, because one of the Allen key is going to be fitted into this. One of the Allen key is going to be fitted into this with all the screws. And this Allen key, the big, so there is a small Allen key and a big Allen key. The small Allen key is for all the bolts here, and the big Allen key is something that we are going to use in the fixing of the back that I will show you further in the. So in total we have taken down 10 screws, as you see in the holes here. Now we are going to, first and foremost, step number 2. So step number one was checking the seat and taking out the hardware, taking out the screws. Now the screws, all these screws, they come with washers. Ensure that you don't lose the washers, otherwise the installation will not be proper. Now these are the handles which are provided along the chair. So what step number 2 is fixing of these handles as per the slot. So if you see, there are these slots where the handles have to be fixed. So we're going to do the installation of the handle. Click. So the handles are going to be screwed the way as you can see. So all the 6 screws along with the washers have to be screwed very well tightly onto the back seat. Now ensure that this alignment is intact. If you see the alignment between the seat and the handle, see this alignment. So though it will automatically, when once you tighten this will automatically fall in place, but in case you find any discrepancy, before you tighten this, it has got a maneuverability where you can move this slightly to the left or right, but automatically it will fall into place. So this was step number two. Now if you see, we are ready with the seat and handles. Now the best part of this chair is that these handles are adjustable, so you can adjust them. So we are now moving on to the step number two. So for step number two, what we are going to do is we are going to put the, so I am going to bring this to the, I am going to use the box to do the installation. Now step number three is, if you see these holes, now I have to match these holes with the mechanism. Now we will again use the balance screws that we left, the four screws that we left in the step number one, and we're going to put them in the mechanism. Now to start with, the screws have to be just gently put so that the mechanism automatically, you know, comes into the position. Use the Allen key to tighten this. So we're not going to tighten it completely, just gently we have to tighten so that it is in position. Now this was step number three. Now we come to step number four. Now step number four, we showed you the chair back. So the chair back has got a bracket, as you can see here. Now this also comes with the screws. So first we have to, so now the bigger Allen key was for this. So we told you in the beginning that there are two Allen keys. One is small Allen key, which is used for the installation in the seat. Then there is a big Allen key, which is used for installation of the back. So we are going to open these screws. Then the whole idea is that we are going to put these three screws with this back. If you see, there are three holes here, 1, 2, and 3. So these three holes are going to be screwed with these three bolts. So these bolts effectively are going to go in these holes, and this back bracket has to be. Now one thing very important while you are doing the installation, you have to ensure that this distance, if you see, if I can put my two fingers here, this distance has to be equal so that this is in alignment. Now as you see, we have matched the holes. Now we are just putting the screws in position before tightening them. Now the balance screws, which we didn't tighten earlier because we wanted to have the alignment of the whole chair, we are tightening them. So don't use, see, the way to tighten this is that once you tighten it, you just put little pressure and make it tight, but don't kind of over stress it, otherwise it can result in damage. So we are ready to go. So this was step four of the chair. Now if you see, the chair is ready with the handle, the seat and the back all aligned. Now the last step of the chair, we come to the last step, the step number five of the chair. We have the base and we have the gas lift. So please take care while removing the packing. The packing is provided to prevent the damages. still while you remove the packing, please make sure that you don't get hurt. Do it very gently. So this is how we, now the cylinder has to be placed. It's top, this is to face towards the top, and you place it on the base, and then use the narrow section upward, and so you have to pick the chair with both the handles, and if you see the bottom, this has to and we're good to go. If you see, now the gasper is working. Now, just to give you the features of this chair, again, this chair comes with a synchronized tilting mechanism, where if you see, the movement of the back is twice as the movement of the seat to give extra comfort to the user. Now, if this lever is to take the chair, to increase the or decrease the height of the chair, and this lever that you see at the bottom, if you want the back movement to be little tight, you have to rotate it clockwise. If you want it little loose, it has to be rotated anti-clockwise. Lock position. So this is your chair being ready. So wish you all the very best and happy working. Thank you.